Hi, I'm Steve Demme, and we're going to talk about fun things to do outside the home. We live in an area right now on one night a week. They have bowling, which is only 50 cents a game after you pay $5 to get in the alley. But instead of $4 a game, you can pay $5 to walk in and then 50 cents a game after that, 50 cents for shoes, very cheap. My son John and I have done a lot of bowling, especially when people from work come with us or for friends. It even makes it more enjoyable for him. But one of the things we're talking about here is family activities. So bowling is one. Miniature golf. We've done a lot of miniature golf as our family. We still do it sometimes on special occasions where my adult kids will all go to a certain, we have to break it up into a couple groups when we go through miniature golf, but fun activity. But what I'm really trying to encourage people to do is not have to go to bowling alleys or miniature golf or bike riding on trails, which is something that we like to do occasionally, but what can we do in our own home? There used to be a speaker, his name was Russell T. Conwell, who gave a talk called Acres of Diamonds. And the idea was, there's a man in Africa, as I remember it, who used to, he wanted to find treasure, and he went all over the place looking for treasure. And it turned out when he came home, he dug up in his own yard and he found acres of diamonds. And that was the theme of the story. And by the way, he took the proceeds from that talk and would give it to orphanages. But the idea was he had acres of diamonds. He didn't need to go looking other places for it. He had it right in his own home. So here's some things that we did in our own home. One of our nice family activities was croquet. Croquet has six colors. And we had four sons and my wife and I, we all played. And so we did a lot of playing croquet. Oftentimes, I remember when the kids were younger, it would be a Sunday afternoon activity. And now we play it when maybe everybody gets together for Easter or for Mother's Day. We're at our home and we play croquet as a family still to this day. We do things like bocce ball. Now we have cornhole. But we just like to do things as a family. And, you know, we have a lot of guys in our family, a lot of testosterone. And my wife taught us early on, taught us, all five of us, she taught us how to say good game after we would lose. So we want to be competitive, but we also want to be sportsmanlike. We play a lot of wiffle ball. I know this sounds funny, but I remember playing wiffle ball in our front yard where we used to live. And not everybody was athletic. But if you get one of those big red wiffle ball bats and the big ball, almost anybody from 2 or 3 years old and up can play wiffle ball because you can hit that big monster bat. And if they can't even hit it, then the pitcher could probably bounce it off the bat. But we used to play wiffle ball. I remember a fun time is after we've been playing it as a family, the church that we were attending, it was a small church, and they decided to have a church picnic. And they said, whew. We were have a little planning meeting. What do we do with the kids? And someone said, well, let's get a video. And I said, no, how about if we play a game as a church? And they said, what do you mean? And really, I could tell that they were a little skeptical whether we were going to pull this off. So we brought up our big red wiffle ball bat on the day of the picnic, divided up the teams. I think we had 15 on a team. And we said, okay, from the youngest, who may have been 3 or 4 years old, all the way up to the oldest, of which I was the oldest on my team. And we had two teams that way, and we batted through the order. So every inning, all 15 people batted. And we kept score, and we made outs. So this wasn't just T-ball. But we played as families, all together. And it was an eye-opening experience. And a lot of those families afterwards said, boy, that was so wonderful. We'd never seen anything like it. And you know, the adults got to play with the kids. And you remember when you were a kid, how much more fun it is not to play just with your peers, but to play with parents and young people and all kinds of physical capabilities. That was fun. Duck, duck, goose. My son John loved that game when he was younger. And we would, birthday parties. We still have old movies of birthday parties when one of the activities was we'd all sit in a big circle in the front yard and one person would walk around the outside tapping duck, 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 and he'd finally tap someone and say, goose. And then he would run around the circle trying to get into their spot. And they would run and try to catch him before he got into that spot. Duck, duck, goose. Great family game. Now it just makes me tired to think about getting up and down off the ground. Sword fighting. Probably didn't expect this one. One of my boys saved up the money, took the initiative, and ordered real swords. Sandy called me. She said, "Do you know what your sons are doing now?" And I said, "No." She said, "They're playing with real swords in the woods." I said, "Can you tell them to maybe put a lid on it until I get home so we could talk about it?" And when we got together, I said, "You know, those swords are dangerous. I've got some real wood, some maple that I'd gotten for a pretty good price. And I said, how about if you take my jigsaw and carve out the outline of swords, whatever, knives, and then go to a carpet store," and they got carpet padding and they covered it, and they covered it with duct tape, and they did it all in their own initiative. It was wonderful. And pretty soon the whole neighborhood was having sword fights because Isaac, who was the initiator, had written away and bought a book on medieval sword fighting techniques. And they not only had swords, they had scimitars, they had lances. I don't even know all the different names of them because I got smart kids. And then I remember that summer we went to a family camp and I was in charge of the activities. And I said, "Isaac, would you like to lead a workshop on sword fighting?" "Sure." Turned out it was a waiting list to get into that workshop. But it started at home because we were sword fighting as a family. He's a good sword fighter. Today, we have kayaks. And there's a lake nearby us and we throw the kayaks on the car or in a trailer. We run up there and we float together and play around on the lake. And we played paintball when they were younger. When paintball first came out, I was dragging my heels on it. Didn't have money, number one. Number two, was a little concerned. And so we encouraged the kids to get slingshots and work goggles. Pretty soon they had wrist rockets, which are just probably more powerful than some of the paintball guns. So finally the kids saved up their money and they bought paintball guns with little CO2 cartridges, and then they kept upgrading until they had Spider Elite, I think, and they got me one. I used to play with them. I was not good at it. I was just a big target. I had a rugby shirt, and I just felt like I was target practice. And Johnny was usually on my team, and then I learned about the expression friendly fire. So I had to be careful where John was. But anyway, we played paintball. Sandy never played that one with us, so that wasn't a full family activity, but the boys and I played a lot of paintball. We lived near some woods, and their friends would come over, and the buddies from church, and we would run around the woods and shoot each other. So there's just some ideas for you. Backyard bonanza, and I hope that you'll find acres of diamonds in your own backyard. Bless us, Lord, in mining those diamonds and creating these wonderful memories. In Jesus' name, amen.